In today's video, I wanted to take a look at getting a Netgear LB1120 or 1121 LTE cellular modem hooked up with Google Fi as the cellular provider. Now, I've been a subscriber with Google Fi for a couple of years now, and I greatly enjoy the service for a number of reasons. One of the little-known benefits that you can get with Google Fi is a free data-only SIM. The great thing about this is that you pay nothing for the SIM card itself, and you only pay for the data usage that you consume. In my case, I was looking at this to do cellular backup for my home network. Seemed great, since I would pay nothing for the SIM card, and then only if I failed over my home internet connection to the cellular backup would I be paying just for the data that I used. So let's go ahead and take a look at the steps required to set this up. First, we'll go to Google Fi's website, which I'm already logged in, and we'll go ahead and go down to Manage Plan. We'll scroll down a little bit, and you can see that I already have a couple of devices, including the SIM card that I already ordered for this project. If we needed to order another one, however, we could just go to Add Data Only SIM, and it'll prompt us to tell us a little bit about how the pricing and structure works. We'll hit Continue, and it will ask us to make sure that our device that we're using on this network is compatible. Now, in our case, the modem isn't technically officially supported. However, it does support the LTE cellular bands that T-Mobile uses on the back end, so we should have no problem running this. Next, we'll go ahead and click Order SIM. The site will prompt us to confirm our address and confirm $0 shipping, and we can go ahead and hit Confirm Purchase. Now, again, in my case, I already ordered one of these and it just arrived, so let's go ahead and jump to looking at setting up the device. Once your SIM card arrives from Google Fi, you'll get a pretty minimal looking envelope that contains your SIM card and a secret code, which I've gone ahead and blacked out because I've already used it, but you'll need that to go ahead and activate your SIM card. So let's go ahead and pop this out. And an additional thing that you'll need is an adapter, because the SIM card that's provided by Google Fi is a little bit smaller than what we need for the modem. So we'll go ahead and snap this in here, if I can turn it around the right way. There we go. All right. Next, we'll go ahead and take a look at our modem. This is the LB1121. I went ahead and opted for the Power over Ethernet model. While this still does have a power port, we're going to go ahead and use this with just a single Ethernet connection powered by a PoE switch. This is just to go ahead and reduce the cabling, and my PoE switch is backed up by a battery backup, so if I ever were to lose power, the modem would still retain power because it would be getting it from the switch itself. All right, on the bottom you'll see a couple of things. We will need to note the username and password that is used to go ahead and log into the web interface once we get it up and running. And then right under here, we'll see our SIM card slot. This is going to go ahead and pop down and open up, and we'll place our SIM card inside. Can be a little bit finicky. You might have to hold it down a little bit and then make sure that it closes properly. We'll go ahead and put our cover back on, and we're all set and ready to go. Okay, so now I have the modem plugged into my desktop just to go ahead and get it set up and running. So first we'll go ahead and see if our modem is online. And it looks like we are in fact getting an IP address from our default gateway, which we'd expect, 192.168.5.1, which is the modem. That address is also printed on the bottom of the modem, so we know that that's what we need to hit. So go ahead and launch a web browser and go to that address. Then we can go ahead and log in with the password that we found on the bottom of the device. And first we'll see that we're actually already connected to T-Mobile for 3G internet. Now the problem here is that our provider is Google Fi, not T-Mobile, so we may run into connectivity issues. So the first thing that we'll need to do is go ahead and change our settings to Google Fi. So we'll go down to the settings menu and over to the mobile tab. And then under APN, we see that it's already set up for T-Mobile as we see before. We can click Add for a new provider. For name, we'll put in Google Fi. And for APN, we'll type in H2G2. And then go ahead and hit Save. And now we're going to select that as our active profile. And we'll even go ahead and just delete the T-Mobile profile. Now, sometimes this may connect automatically. I've found it best to go ahead and just go back to the software page and restart the device. Okay, so now the device is back online and we do have our 4G connection. It doesn't say Google Fi, and I found that the interface is a little bit buggy. Sometimes it will, sometimes it won't, sometimes it'll just show this. But we are connected to the appropriate carrier now. So the other thing I want to look at is a couple of additional settings we might want to configure. So we'll go to Settings, and over to Advanced, and under the LAN tab, we have a couple of configuration options. So for one, we can choose whether or not we want this to operate in bridge mode or router mode. The difference here is that if we're operating this in router mode, then the modem itself is taking in the external connection from Google Fi and translating that into a connection that multiple different computers could use on a local network. In addition, our modem will hand out IP addresses to the systems on the network so that they're all able to connect out over the cellular connection. Now, in my case, it might be better to use something called bridge mode. And in this case, I'm going to be hooking up the modem directly to my home firewall. And bridge mode would allow the modem to pass through the external IP addressing and connectivity straight to my firewall, so that from my firewall's perspective, it looks like it just has another internet connection, not that it's connecting through another router through a cellular modem. Changing these settings is going to depend on how you intend on using the modem and what effect you want to accomplish. Okay, that's it for this video. If you're interested in seeing how I perform the cellular backup using my home firewall, check out the next video, which should be out soon.